Hey everyone, Leland Best out here at Best at YouTube. Just wanted to cut a somewhat quick video. Not sure how long this is going to take, but I needed to update a video that you may have seen me in out there on page one of Google for the last couple of years. This is the video that you may have seen out there at one point or another if you've ever decided to get involved with transcribing videos from the YouTube closed captioning section. I felt that it was about time that I did a little update to that video, so I'm actually going to cut another and kind of go into some of the other aspects that I've noticed YouTube has made some changes to, so that we can get a little fresher perspective on how we can use that in our ability to transcribe videos automatically through YouTube. I'm going to go ahead and head over here to a video I just created a couple of days ago. This is a short 2.5 minute video, and it's going to fire up real quick. That's me in the video, obviously. And what I want to do is get over to my video manager so I can actually edit this. But I wanted to show you something with the video itself right up front, and that is how the closed captioning subtitles work. I didn't do a transcription for it yet, but I allowed YouTube to create the transcription automatically for me. Now, videos that start with dead air or intro videos or anything of that nature, because of that, can not necessarily work properly with YouTube's closed captioning process. You usually want to start with a fresh video where there's instant talking or at least someone giving some type of presentation. And you'll never expect perfection here, and you'll see what I mean by that. If I play this video with the closed captioning on, I'll turn this on. It's an auto-generated captioning, and you'll see right off the bat how this starts. Now, you might not be able to hear the video very well, but at least try to listen in at what's being said versus what shows up on the screen.
Hey everyone, Leland Best here at Best at YouTube. Thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel today.
Okay, now it looks as though rather than stopping by the YouTube channel today, somebody may lead to jail today. We definitely need to fix that because we want our message to come across in the right fashion. And in order to do so, we're going to want to make sure that the text matches what's being said. So I'm going to head over to my video manager. And I'm going to jump into that particular video. If I go to the edit tab, at the video I want to process, I can go right to the subtitle and closed captioning portion that YouTube has so graciously allowed us to utilize. And you'll see here right off the bat, we can add our own subtitles or closed captioning. If we happen to have a transcription already prepared, we can just drop that in frame by frame and get it to line up with the video. But lo and behold, we'll be able to discover, as I showed in the previous video, within a day or two, if the text is clear or at least obvious to YouTube's voice processing software that something's being said that could be transcribed, it'll generate an automatic English translation of the video. Now we can go in here, and as you'll see, it's portioned out with a timeline both along the side of the text and underneath the video. Now this is an aspect that was not available when I made the first video. So what I want to do is get into the edit mode. Now I could download this, and this was what I showed in the previous videos, that you could download the BTT file, which is simply a text file associated with Notepad and Windows or any other editor, and you could crop out the timeline and paragraph the text and take the text and pop it in your description for your YouTube video. Now I've since then discovered that there's really a little easier way to do that rather than trying to just grab this text and take it out and process it in an editor. We will still do that, but we're going to do it after the fact. So what we want to do is go ahead and get into the edit mode that YouTube has given us here. And this was always present before, but not in quite the same format that they have now. We could edit several things from this perspective. We can edit the text manually. We can edit the timeline framing for when the text starts and stops, and you can see how it pops up on the screen. There's also the ability to adjust these through here that grants you a rewrite of the timeline so that you can cut short or crop out some of the things that are here. You can completely erase these frames if you'd like to keep them from there, but you can see here how I shortened up a particular part of this frame from 4.5 seconds. There's a gap now from 4.5 to 4.9 when honestly these usually line up. The last moment of one frame should be the starting time of the next frame, etc. So you'll see 9.3 to 9.3, 12.4 to 12.4. That's basically a continuous flow of text on the closed captioning. But if we go back to that first frame and we play the video, we're going to see how far off this really is. Now you want this button this box checked off to pause the video while typing, and this will allow for a much smoother editing process. So let's fire it up and see what we got. And here we go.
Hey everyone, Leland Best here at Best at YouTube.
Okay, let's get that straight right off the bat. Now I could probably make this all one frame. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to get rid of this line. I'm going to take that frame right out, and I'm going to adjust this to the 4.9 second block so that they tie right into each other. So basically I've put this all on one line. I'm going to start over.
Hey everyone, Leland Best here at Best at YouTube.
So you can see that now that one frame entails the entire 3.2 seconds of audio track, and the closed captioning matches. So let's move on to the next frame.
Thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel today.
Okay, this was supposed to be the YouTube channel, not me lead to jail today. So thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel today. You might want to avoid the stacking that's going to take place as you go through the edits. Obviously my B's and U's are backwards today. Okay, so let's play that and see what we've got now.
Thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel today. I just wanted to give everyone a heads up on what's going to be.
So let's just take that one right out of there. Throw the on in here. We'll make that. I'll take this one out. And make this one a 9.3. So you can see how you can simply frame these together. And get this one up out of the way. Get the Best at YouTube brand in there. Change this one up. And I know some of what I said in here. Alright, so let's start from here and see where that takes us.
What's going to be taking place out here at Best at YouTube? There are going to be some big changes coming down the road. You've probably, if you have subscribed to my channel in the past, had seen me promoting several different things in the internet world.
Okay, so I'm actually going to take this out of here because I know it's coming up in the next frame. Pardon the pause. This is another brand, and obviously YouTube cannot identify branding when it comes to any of the text in the document, and it's not going to capitalize or add any punctuation, so sometimes it's convenient to get in there and actually make it easier for the individual to read it properly so they see where you're pausing, because if they can't hear your voice, they don't really know whether it's a run-on sentence or if it's something that, you know, you've just put together in a haphazard kind of way. But what I definitely wanted to focus on the most is that you have an audience of hearing impaired individuals who may want to get your message, and the best thing for you to do is to accommodate that message for them by coming in and fixing up the closed captioning, or at least doing a transcription before you start your video and then uploading the data. And I think it's a little harder at some points to get all this information in here, unless of course you've followed your script to a T. And if that's the case, fine, that works out for some people to write scripts. Me, I don't particularly like to write scripts. I just like to go head on into it and create whatever comes out. But let's go back into where we can take this information now. Now you can see where the timeline has been established and all the text is starting to come together. Now what we want to look at is how can we get this information into the description of the video. So we can publish these edits, which is going to help obviously the ranking of the video, because now not only is the text going to be proper in the closed captioning, and YouTube loves it when we get in there and start making things proper, But also the fact that anything I say in the video that is keyword related to my niche is going to show up now in text form within the closed captioning and to the description portion. So we have our English closed captioning. This is our edited version, which we created when we first opened the automatic version and published it. And now, like I mentioned in the previous video, is we can go in here and we can download the file. Now I tend to just grab the first file format here, which is a VTT or video transcription text file, and I might not be saying that properly, but that's what I call it, and I could probably clarify that in the description when I finish this. What I was teaching in the previous video is that you can simply take this text file, this web VTT file, take out some of the formatting. Now, one thing to consider here is you may not want to take out all of the timeline functionality that's in this text, because when you do put this over into the description, these timelines, or at least if you give one portion of the timeline, you can just give a starting time, will actually be identified by Google in the description, so that people will have a link available to them that they can click on and get to that immediate part of the video without having to watch. Say if it's a 40-minute video and there's a particular spot in the middle that they're interested in, and you have that timeline identified in your description at, say, 20 minutes, there's this great information they want, they can simply pick on that link and go right to it. And I can probably give you a quick idea how that works here in a minute. But what I did want to do is touch again once on how to pull all of these timelines out of here in a somewhat quick fashion. You can come up here to edit and replace, and we can start with simply the zero factor. Actually, let me do this before I do that. I'm going to save some of this information so that I can show you how the timelines work. I'm going to copy that out into my clipboard before I make any edits. But what I am going to do is I'm going to edit and replace, and I'm going to take all these numbers out. Now, I could go through and highlight each individual frame and pull it out with a delete key, but I found a little quick way to do this is to just do a numeric search with a replace with a delete. So if you hit the delete button, you're entering a string in there that you can't see, but then you can go ahead and replace all. And you can see that just pulled all the zeros out. I can do that with the 1 and replace all, and the 2 and replace all, and go through the entire 1 through 9 so that I can get all these numbers out of here. And this way, what I leave behind in the timeline is simply a colon hyphen caret string, and you'll see what I mean here in a minute, which is this portion right here for the timeline. I can copy that, put that in here, and go ahead and replace all those. Now, what I have to do is simply cancel, and I have a complete file of nothing but text. Now, obviously, Google or YouTube, not that they really differ much, it's not going to use numeric values in the transcription. So we can rest assured that when we do those deletions, all we're deleting are the actual timelines. You're not going to remove any data from the actual file itself, so you don't have to worry about that, but you may want to go back and replace some of the text with some actual numeric values so that you can incorporate those into your text. So what you can do from here, obviously, is just go in and start getting this into more of a paragraph form for your description and pull that up so that, you know, you're going to have an introduction maybe to your video. And you don't have to use the whole file. And honestly, in larger videos, you're not going to be able to use the entire transcription because it's just not going to fit in the YouTube description box. So keep in mind, this is really just a means to pull some information, maybe keyword, you know, targeted information out of your video that was originally on a soundtrack, and get it into text form so that the search engines can locate it in your video page a little easier than what it might be previously. So let's go over from there, and again, you can save that file, you can format that file any way you like, and then just copy and paste this data out of the text editor into your description form, and you'll be all set to go. So you have the published copy here of the English translation. If we do screw it up really bad, we can always go and simply delete that transcription. Now, that's the one that's going to override, so if we go back to the beginning of the video and watch, even though there was an automated feature there, and there is still one there, We can go ahead and play this.
Hey everyone, Leland Best here at Best at YouTube. Thanks for stopping by my YouTube channel today. I just wanted to give everyone a heads up on what's going to be taking place out here at Best at YouTube.
Okay, so now we have a perfect matchup with the text in the transcription with the video, and we can see that that's working just fine. Now, if we wanted to, we could see what else we have here. Go right back to the subtitles so you can see what I mean. Here we still have the automatic transcription that was done, but it's going to go with whatever we edited. So we're going to go back over to our info and settings, and what we wanted to do before was actually get the description in here. If I copy this out and go over here and paste it in my description, what you'll discover was when we save this, and you would actually just go in and add descriptions of what's being said at these particular portions. And there you go. Now this obviously, okay, it only goes to the second, so I made the mistake of not showing the tenths, hundredths, and thousands of seconds. We don't need that. All it'll take it to is the nearest second. So let's say I wanted somebody to be able to watch the video or left a description that, hey, at 12 seconds I talk about how I did this wondrous thing. People can go in here and simply click on the 12 seconds, and as you notice, it went right to the 12 second portion of the video. So that's a really nifty feature that you can use to get people that are not really going to watch your whole video, but you still want to capture their attention. When they see these little timeline, I mean, anybody that has a link to pick on kind of loves picking on things. So when you have that link available for them to just go midway through the video and they know exactly where it is that they can find what it is they're looking for, it gives them that opportunity to have a little bit of control over what they view. So I think for now that'll kind of cover what I wanted to cover when it comes to transcribing your video with YouTube's closed captioning. I hope this has been of some help to you, and if you haven't seen my previous video, I'll leave a link for the original one that sits out on the first page of Google, or if you just Google transcribing videos with YouTube, you'll probably find me out there on page one. You can watch that page video, or you can continue to come back and see where we progress with the one that I've just created. I'm sure I'll either expand on it or at least get the closed captioning cleaned up and change the description around, add some timeline features to it so that you can see in the end how these files can actually help you create better videos out here on YouTube. So once again, this is Leland Best out at Best at YouTube. I appreciate you stopping by and watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, everyone.